Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, my dear brothers and sisters, we are checking delivery of the 27 local government results for the governorship election. It has already been entered by our electronic coalition support secretariat. Again, it has been cross-checked for computational accuracy. Now, what is remaining is, I am now going to copy, it is already projected earlier on, I'm now going to copy from the electronic version onto the original, and I'm now going to display the original for you to see that it is blank. When I finish copying the result from the electronic copy, then I'm now going to make the announcement, and then we round it up, and then make the declaration. Is that clear? Thank you.
This is the result sheet. Is it blank for me?
Blank. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, my brothers and sisters, we have almost come to the end of the coalition and the final announcement. But before I read out the result and make the declaration of the winner of the gubernatorial election, let me not forget to thank each and every one of you for putting in your best, particularly the IT staff, both from headquarters and here in Maiduguri, and our security operatives and allied organizations, without whom we would not have gathered here peacefully and disperse and go back to our homes peacefully. Again, our political parties, they have shown maturity, they have shown caution, they have participated, and I want to single them out and show my gratitude. To the members of the press, who are definitely going to witness and relay it to the appropriate quarters, I must express my profound gratitude for their patience waiting all this long, but we are soon going to get it over. To other invited guests who are here, as observers and other participants, I wish to thank each and everyone for actually finding time to come here either officially or on his own merit to monitor, to see things for themselves, for ourselves. Thank you very much for your patience. Thank you very much for your contribution. And thank you very much for your time. With this, I am now going to sit down with your permission. If you permit me to sit down, I'm going to sit down and then read out the results of the parties and then make the declaration of who won the election that took place on Saturday, 11th of April 2015. Thank you very much once more. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you know that 13 political parties participated in this exercise of the governorship election in Kornoche last Saturday. And the total number of registered voters stands at 1,843,821, which translates to 1,843,820. Number of accredited voters, 758,841, which is 758,841. Out of this, Akwa got 69 votes, Akka got 617,617, APC got 649,919, which is simply 649913. 649 913. 649,913. Is it clear?
Yes.
Thank you. Abka? 2787. 2787. CBP 196. ID 198. 631 LP 384 PDC 244 244 PDB 34771, which is 34,771. Is it clear? TPA 150. TPN 46. TPN 46. SGB 175. SGB 175. Total post cards stands at 690182, which is 690,182. Rejected vote 14772. 14772. 14,772. Total votes cast in Borosi for the governorship is 704954, which is 704,954. I now move on to the declaration. From Sayaganami culture, hereby certify that I was the returning officer for the Borno State Governorship election held on the 11th day of April 2015, that the election was contested, that the candidates received the following votes. That Kashim Shetima of APC, having satisfied requirements of the law and scored the highest number of votes, is hereby declared the winner and returned elected. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Our host
the chairman of the party, the speaker of the Borno State House of Assembly, the director general of our campaign organization, serving and former senators who are about to be sworn in senators, members of the House of Representatives, serving and about to go in, our party leaders, special advisors, honorable commissioners, members of the Borno State House of Assembly, members of our political establishment, gentlemen of the press, and other eminent personalities too numerous to mention. Good afternoon. Let me start by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the Supreme and Giver of power to whoever he wills, at the time he wills. The good people of Borno have once again brought us into office with a unanimous consent. We are most grateful to the people of Borno State, from the south, from the north, and the central parts of the state, who spoke in one strong voice to elect many APC candidates at the March 28th Presidential and National Assembly elections and last Saturday's governorship and state assembly elections. Words cannot adequately convey our debt of gratitude, not just for the massive votes, but also for the immeasurable confidence the people of Borno State have reposed in our administration. Inshallah, we will not let down the people of Borno. Inshallah, and they are no more. Inshallah, wala mustafu kunyaba. I want to use this opportunity to especially thank our parents, sons, daughters, brothers, and sisters displaced from Oberhard and those local government areas, from Boza, from Bama, from Gada, from Kalabalji, from Marti, from Ikwa, from Mapa, from Konduga, from Lenzi, from Monguno, from Kaga. Then we are close from Buzamala, Kukawa, Akira Uba, Monguno, Mobar, Bama, 16 local government areas that were forced to have their elections conducted here in Maiduguri. These sons and daughters of Borno have shown great spirit of bravery, patriotism, and tough democratic sacrifice. The people of these local government areas have lost parents, sons, daughters, brothers, sisters, relatives, and friends. They lost cut across all the lands and breadth of Borno. They have lost their homes, lost their sources of livelihood from farmlands, the shops and offices. They were forcibly confined to living in camps for no fault of theirs. But despite the sense of losing their loved ones, the agony of homelessness and the torture of being transformed from givers to beggars, the people of these local government areas refused to abandon their democratic rights. They stood humbly, flexed, potential kilometers in some cases and under strange circumstances, they mobilized to cast their votes. These internally displaced persons are part of the real heroes of the democratic change Nigeria is experiencing today. We are grateful to these IDPs, sons and daughters of Borno. Let me quickly direct the State Emergency Management Agency and committees saddled with the responsibilities of taking care of all our IDP camps to ensure that on no account should they slow down in providing the needs of these displaced persons. We were not taking care of them mainly to get their votes.
we were taking care of them. It's a matter of our obligations towards them and to meet their fundamental rights as citizens in distress who are entitled to be catered for. SEMA and other committees on IDPs must therefore ensure that no existing welfare activity for IDPs is slowed or stopped because elections are over. The stay of IDPs at council, inshallah, not be longer than necessary, will do everything humanly possible to get them back to their reconstructed homes and communities as soon as practicable. Inshallah, we are immediately setting up an interim emergency team on evaluation and reconstruction of communities to mobilize and start working pieces. While that is going on, we already have a work plan for the convocation of a summit. We will only need to expand the group working on that and then change the focus to holding what we will call Borno Reality and Prospects Summit. We will have only one agenda, and that agenda is to develop a Marshall work plan for both the insurgency Borno. The plan will clearly identify areas will need the support of the federal government, areas will need international support, areas will need support from the private sector within Nigeria, and areas in Borno State government will shoulder. Our target is to hold that summit in June, so that by July, inshallah, a delegation from Borno should be able to pay a visit to ASOROK, and for the first time in recent years. Borno will not be visiting ASOROK as an opposition state that is mostly perceived as a political enemy. We'll be going as an APC-led state government, meeting President Muhammadu Buhari of an APC state. We'll inshallah present before the incoming president our legitimate demand for the construction of our communities, rehabilitation, and reintegration of our displaced citizens. We will, from the outcome of that summit, identify the support we shall demand from the federal government on what to do. What hundreds of thousands of youths on the streets of Maiduguri, Diu, Monguno, and a host of other places, many of whom have been rendered jobless by Boko Haram. We plan to be amongst the pestered of callers on an APC-controlled ASOROK to make constructive demands that are not just but legitimate and urgent. On areas of intervention from foreign drones, I will, after consultation with appropriate bodies, lead reasonable delegations to Kuwait, to Qatar, to build and maintain the Gates Foundation, and wherever we can get support to heal our ailing state. The people of Borno State have taken a very wise decision by choosing to align with the government at the center, especially with the vicious experience, which even on ordinary basis should make Borno the most deserving of attention from the federal government, more than any other federal community in the. We are grateful to all the people of Borno State for voting us for the second term, a very big commendation, and profound appreciation to the APC team, starting from my boss, the state chairman of the APC, the director general of our campaign organization, state executives of the APC, serving and former senators and members of the National Assembly, local government and ward executives, party agents in all polling units, coalition offices, stakeholders, major and minor, from all the 27 local government areas, serving and former public officers, elders of the state, our traditional rulers, leaders and members of clubs and associations, trade and other professional unions, the academia, women and youth organizations, state and federal civil servants, student unions, corporate organizations, gentlemen of the press, and every other person or group. I am might not have mentioned, but who supported our cause. Let me also say that for me, as leader of the APC and re-elected governor of Borno State, this victory will not change me from being the Kashin Shetima you all know. I am very much a constant reminder that power can be very dangerous to the soul of its beneficiary. From my experience, when one is in power, and since scored his way in highly competitive elections, his first task is to fight his own mentality and resist the slightest temptation, the slightest element of negative pride. Pride can be positive when one protects and preserves his own honor and integrity. But negative pride is when one thinks he is all in all, he is the Almighty, and soul keeps up within his environment. It is that kind of pride that goes to the level where someone in power begins to equate himself with God. He begins to think that he is the one who determines the destiny of others and who makes decisions as to who is to be poor, who is to be rich, and who ascends to power. I know and believe that whoever has been the power of God always crashes sooner than he expects, or later on along the ladder. Only God has the power to determine the fate of others. That power is absolutely Him, and this is why God pines and destroys whoever against His powers. I'm very excited with the overwhelming victory of the APC in Borno. God in His graciousness gave us with this victory. For me, it is purely the act of God, because no one would have thought that election itself was going to fall in Borno, especially with the increase massively deployed by some people, by some expired politicians and politicians, to stop the elections from taking place in Borno, all in their plot to overthrow an elected government under a constitutional democracy. It was simply God that stopped them, made the elections not only held, but without wild incidents that were anticipated. Yes, I've been related against so many of us, but I won't blame God. And I don't wish to be called with names associated with sovereign pride as a result of this victory. None of the boundaries of power actually holds any tenacious attraction to me. I will never blame God, and I pray to Allah to protect me and all leaders from negative pride. The people of Borno have made us very proud, but their support is also a big reminder to their huge and deserved expectations from us. Because, like Franklin Delano Roosevelt rightly said, there is a mysterious cycle in human history. To some generations, much is given. For older generations, much is expected. I believe this generation of born ones will have a rendezvous with destiny. Nigerians expect so much from the APC. In fact, changes in their living standard is the real change they seek. The people of Borno expect so much from us. We have a big task ahead of us, especially with many millions of our citizens living outside their communities. We are hitting the ground right away. It is time for work. Election is over. I kindly ask all citizens, especially you supporters of the APC, to be local and to celebrate the product of their ceaseless efforts. Security agencies deserve so much commendation for their professional and non-partisan conduct throughout the election. I want to also pay a special tribute to INEC for really displaying non-partisanship is the conduct of the election. I kindly ask all security agencies to sustain their patriotic duty by suspending law and order in all parts of the state during and after victory celebrations. We must all be humble and magnanimous in victory. The ultimate victory will come after we work together to rebuild and reposition Borno State. This has to be achieved. Borno has suffered. It is time to rebuild Borno. And I want to extend a hand of fellowship to the defeated candidates of various political colorations. Borno belongs to all of us, and let's join hands and give Borno for the greater glory of future generations. Thank you so much. And may God grant us peace and guide us toward the reconstruction and repositioning of our beloved Borno State and the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you.
Haki will hug.